Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to teach you about three hidden features that are my favorite that I think you are not using and that you need to know about on the Behringer Wing. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, the first thing is that on the Behringer Wing Compact, we have this user one and this user two, and we can assign custom channels into that. But the hidden feature that I want to tell you about is that you can actually do this on every single layer of the Behringer Wing. So I can actually go up to my 1 through 12, press View, go to Config, and then I can press this arrow over, and I have an additional 12 channels on this layer that I can place custom channels. So for instance, on my layer here, 13 through 24, I actually have two more vocals on 25 and 26. So I could go to my 13 through 24, and I can then pull it up here in my screen by pressing View and then going Config, and then I can arrow over, and I can just go ahead and drop vocal 7 and 8 into these two faders. So now, if I press my 13 through 24 and I need to quickly adjust my 7 and 8, all I have to do is just press the arrow over and boom, there are my other two channels. Now, one other practical way of doing this is putting your vocal verb and your vocal delay or any of your effects on these four channels that you have here on every single layer. So what I'm going to do is go to my channels 1 through 12, press View, go into Config, and then I'm going to arrow over. And for adding in my reverb and delay here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go bus main up here and then find my vocal verb and my vocal delay and just drop those into these two faders right here. And then I'll do the same thing with my 13 through 24. So I'll take those out and add these two in. And then I can do the same thing on this layer by arrowing over and right here. So boom, boom, add those in. So now what we have is every single fader layer that I have, I can just press the arrow over and boom, there is my vocal verb and my vocal delay. And then if I am on my 13 through 24, I can arrow over and boom, there they are. And then one other tip on this section is that if you double press the 13 through 24 while your faders are shifted over, it will bring you back to the home spot. So if you go to 1 through 12 and you arrow over, if you press it one more time, it will automatically go back to the home portion of that fader layer. So that is your first tip on how to make your workflow a little bit faster. Now, the second hidden feature that I want to talk about is actually in the library structure. So if you press library, and we have our different things here. So I have a couple snapshots here. I could make a snippet, but the hidden feature is using a tilde, and that will actually give you a second layer inside the naming to be able to add notes for that. So let's actually make a snippet real fast for saying changing my vocals from song to song. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to snippets and I'm going to add items, and I'm just going to select all of my channels for this, because this is multiple songs. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to scope the fader and the mute, and I'll press add. And so at this point, now I can make the changes that I need to for my mutes and my fader adjustments, and then save that. So for instance, on this song, my vocal 7 and 8 are actually not being used, and vocal 4 is leading. So there we go. Here is the adjustment. And this is actually song 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press save, and we're going to call this song 1. And save. Now, on the next one, it has vocal 1 leading. So here we go, and we actually have 7 and 8 back on stage at this point. So here we go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press save, and this is going to be song 2. Now, as I go between these two, so I can press song 1, and I can press load and confirm, boom, I have my vocal 4 leading, and then if I go to song 2, I can press load, and boom, I have my vocal 1 leading. But one thing that I can do is I can add a tilde in the actual naming of this snippet and give myself a little bit more detail. So I can go to song 1 and I can press rename. And what I can do is I can add this little tilde right here, and I can say vocal 4 lead. vocal four leads. And so now what we can see is this says song one, and then there's a little line underneath that that says vocal four leads. And so now we can go to song two, and I can rename this, and I can put a tilde, and I can put vocal one leads. There we go. So now I have song one, and I have song two. So if I go load, boom, it's loaded. And if I go load, boom, we can do that. But then we can actually take this and do this for any save of any of our library. So any show, any snapshot, any snippet, clip, effect, channel preset, all of those things, we can actually go and apply a little note on the bottom side of the naming of our specific file. Now, the very last hidden feature on the Behringer Wing that I want to talk about today, I actually have to go grab, and that is that we can actually plug in a mouse into our Behringer Wing. And so I have this wireless mouse here, and I have a USB stick, and we can toss it right up here, and I can now use this mouse with my Behringer Wing for adjusting things. So right off the bat, if I go to, say, my kick, and I want to adjust some of the EQ, I can actually bring my mouse, and I can click on any of these things and adjust them. And what's really nice is it gives you the ability of making adjustments pretty easily. So you can grab, say, the gain and raise it or lower using the scroll wheel of the mouse. And this is actually great for also patching. So if we go to our routing and then we go to our channels, and we can just easily navigate this with our mouse. So this gives you an extra layer of adjustment using a mouse if you prefer using a mouse, or you can obviously use the touchscreen that's built in on the Wing. Now, these three tips are just a way of speeding up your workflow and making your console feel more at home, giving you more time to actually mix rather than adjusting things. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make, or if there's a feature that you love that I didn't talk about today, post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.